still says good. Well, hi. Okay, this is Ginger Cook. John says, little in Michigan says I'm alive, and it's true. I feel very alive. Wavy hand, hello. And those kind of, come on, let me have a little fun here. I'm in Houston, Texas, and John Little, our moderator, and the other partner in GingerCookLive.Gallery is in Michigan. And how this works, for those of you who are new, that joined us for the first time, is I have this nifty cell phone. It's connected to my ear, like so ear pods, and then you type in your question, and then John relays it to me, and then I somehow tell you. Now, here's the deal. We have normally extremely successful live broadcasts. Apparently, you two is undergoing some growing pains. Cinnamon, my daughter, our chirper, was here this morning, and she said that it was a bit of a challenge broadcasting. We certainly had that last night. Last night, we did this full tutorial on how to do an abstract, and it was really one of my better ones, and I thought it was just great. It was a cookie ginger crumb. Let me just turn it upside right like this. This is what we painted. Now, you guys, this is, we went ahead because we always record what we do. John was up half the night getting this back up on YouTube for you guys so that you'd have the complete lesson. We even edited it a little bit, and I added some stuff. So this lesson, this is a full tutorial. This is up there on, what's the title of this? I forget. How to Paint an Abstract or something. Anyway, so something like that. I don't know. It occurred to me at the time, and of course, we don't actually have a title for this painting yet because there's this contest involved, and we asked, earlier in the week, we asked people, I just put it up on Facebook real quick, and we got about 25 names, and then John put them up under our Contact Us contest form on GingerCookLive.Gallery, and then what happens now is that some of you got your names picked, and then so if you have friends that want to go over to our website, use the contest form only, you can then vote for the name you like. Of course, if you have see your name that you chose, vote for yourself. And we'll have two prizes. The first person is going to win the person whose name we picked, you know, got the most votes for the painting, they're going to win one of these downloadable lessons. We have over 15 lessons that you can download. So for instance, like this rainbow rose right here, if you wanted to, you know, win that, isn't that cool? Or maybe this one that's coming up, right? You can hang on to it to see if we come up with something else. This is, I'm going to show you, no one's seen this yet. Are you ready? No one's seen this yet. This is a new painting that's coming up in the future that'll be available for download and purchase. Isn't that cool? Isn't that pretty? So again, somebody will be, you'll be able to pick the picture of your choice. There'll be a step-by-step lesson. And of course, if you're in the group that bet on the winning name and it has the most votes, then you'll be in a drawing, random drawing, and we'll also pick a name out of that. Maybe 20, 30 people voted for a particular name. And then if you're in the random group, then you can also pick out something. So that's the contest rules. It will be over a week from this Saturday. So you have time to rally your friends and say, go to GingerCookLive.Gallery and please vote for my name. I think that would be great. So one entry per person. So, all right, now put this away. Now I know, what? Yeah. Okay, this is a really good question. Who's the name of the person that asked that question, John? I think that's a prize winning question. All right, Debbie, this is a prize winning question. I got to tell you, that is a prize when no one's ever asked us that before. So Debbie, if you go to GingerCookLive.Gallery and then look in our store, pick out the lesson you'd like and we will send you the code for that. Because you have asked a phenomenal question. And the question, you guys are going, yeah, but what did she ask, you guys? What did she ask? She wanted to know, if you went to a, say, garage sale and found an old canvas, A, how could you tell if it was an oil painting or an acrylic? And B, if you gessoed over it a few times, would it really matter? And that is a really good question. And the sad thing is, I have no idea. I can't tell. Maybe there's some way to tell. I don't know what it is. If we ever find out, we'll share it with everybody. That would be a good question. You know who's going to know is our friend Daniel down at Jerry's Artorama, who knows all. I will call him tomorrow and find out and post it, because I have no idea how you could tell if there's some little sneaky way, like drop some water on it, does it do some weird thing. But I can tell you, if it's oil paint, I don't care if it's 100 years old, it's not a good plan to paint over it. Canvas is so cheap these days, there's really absolutely no reason to buy a canvas at a garage sale. What you want to buy at a garage sale is maybe an old frame or something, you know, but I don't think you need to buy a canvas. So that being said, that was an excellent question, and so you have won a prize. Ha! We started out the evening with a prize. All right, tonight we're going to be painting this hotel. It is part of our European Village collection. I recommend that you do these on a 6x8 gallery wrap canvas, because they can be stood up. See how we've painted the top of this? And they're really cute. And you have this, you put these around the house or set them on a window ledge or hang them on a wall in kind of different heights. And we'll have like 10 or 12 in the series that you can collect. Here's our flower shop. Someone caught the other night, they wrote me on Facebook and said, I had spelled this wrong. I did. I forgot the U. But I fixed it in the computer, and I'll fix it on here. It's Boutique. Here it is, the boutique Chapelier. That's the hat shop. So we have a hat shop, flower shop. We're going to have a bookshop. We're going to have all kinds of great stores that you can collect and have as a fun series. That's our series. So tonight, what I'd like you to do is consider painting a 6x8 canvas dark brown. So I had it right here. Oh, how is this even possible? I had this right here. I had the canvas and the tablet and everything right here, ready to show everybody. Ah, here it is. It's just a little desk. It's just a joke between John and I. One can lose anything. Someone wrote and asked, what are the canvases that you're using? These are 100% cotton canvases. Now, again, I would still recommend doing a gallery wrap for these, but if you just want to paint along and then do it later, that's okay too. This is what we do most of our live classes on, and it's like, you know, $6 for 10 sheets, and they tear off. And the linen ones are called Centurions, and only Jerry's Artorama sells these. So, okay, so that's what I'm saying. Paint this burnt umber and dry it. So I'm going to give you a head start to be doing that while I'm chatting with everybody, and people are getting kind of caught up. The colors we're going to be using tonight are our old friends. We're going to be wanting both blues, phthalo blue and ultramarine blue. A cad yellow medium, yellow oxide, dosing purple, cad red medium, naphthol crimson, and burnt umber. So again, our white's always put on in a log like that. And we're going to have some ultramarine blue here, which I forgot to write down, but there it is, a little ultramarine blue. And then we're going to do phthalo blue. And that's a really good question. And now, shall I confess, John, something awful? I'm going to confess. I have gone to garage sales and bought canvases and painted over them, big ones, and I had no idea. I just didn't care. You know what I mean? If it didn't last a million years, I was okay with that. But it's not recommended, so I can't, in good faith. It's like when a doctor says, do you think I should come in for an appointment? They always say, oh, yes, you should come in, right? Because if, you know, something happens to you and they say, you sound okay to me, that won't cut it. Make sense? So, again, the party line, the story we're all telling is that you really can't paint over an oil painting with something, except another more oil. Now, that being said, there was this artist in England who did, for years, would go and buy these portraits of old people's dead ancestors, you know, all done, you know, with a little... you know, fancy ruffles, things that were, you know, maybe how they looked in the 1600s, 1700s, okay? Here's the yellow oxide. And then he would put faces on them of dogs that he thought went with the outfit. And he would paint right over the oil painting, the old oil painting, and do these beautiful dogs, and then sometimes the dogs would have earrings to match or whatever. They were hysterical. I think they still sell them. It was a very clever thing. But I'm pretty sure he wasn't using acrylics. And you know what? Even if he was, He was doing it for the prints, not the originals anyway. So, all right, here's a little dazzling purple. Okay, and you're going to want a ruler. You're going to want a quarter inch tape, too, by the way. Just saying, you're going to want those things. Here's Cad Red Medium. And at some point, we may want some naphthol crimson, so I'm going to put that out, a little bit of that out. Okay. Naphthol crimson. And here we go. Now, what do we got here? Burnt umber, okay? So those are our colors that we want for this evening. And we want the half inch tape. And I'll tell you what, quarter inch tape would be really nice too. But you know, maybe we'll just fake it. Okay, so that being said, everybody, you should have had a chance to kind of dry that and letting you guys catch up. Just give us a smiley face if you're painting along with us tonight, okay? Let's move the turtle. People asked me last night what the turtle's for. He's kind of a brush rest, is what our turtle's for. It kind of rests the brushes. I want to start with a pencil. I thought I'd show you what these guys look like when they come. These are general charcoal crayons, and they come with a little pencil sharpener. They're white charcoal pencils, and what's cool about them, isn't trying to get them out of the package. That isn't one of their cool features. That's okay. We're going to get these out of the package here like that. Ha. Ha. There you go. They come with their own little pencil sharpener, which is immensely handy. And what I like about these is they go in my electric pencil sharpener. Okay. So what we want to do is just generally lay out this picture. So, okay. So if you're painting along with us, give us a heads up real quick. I wanted to get, you know, we're going to give you just a second to get yours dry. I want to tell you about some of the other stuff we've been doing this month. And July is a fantastic month for us. We have got some of the best paintings ever. One painting that people are really looking forward to doing is this one. It is our Garden Steps. And this will be on gingercooklive.gallery for our members. And at the end of the month, this is a really cool one. And this is 11 by 14. And so you might really enjoy painting that. People have been asking when that was coming up. In a couple of weeks, we're going to be doing these abstract horses, all right? How cool is that? Abstract horses. And again, these are every Thursday on gingercooklive.gallery, we have what we call a featured release. This is one of our featured releases, and it's on our calendar. We like to give you a heads up on what's happening. Of course, this week we're doing the canal. And the canal scene, I think I have that somewhere around here I can show you. And then next week, we're going to do something really simple. It's called Tortuga Surf, and it's just a happy, really go-lucky surfboards and little outfits and stuff in a beach scene. It's the vacation we all want to take this summer, whether we get to take one or not. So anyway, that's what's going on with us. And if you go to Pinterest, Ginger Cook Live, all one word on Pinterest, and you can often see way up ahead what we're doing and what our students are doing. If you sent me something through GingerCook92 on Facebook, and I often post your pictures up on Pinterest of what you've painted from our lessons. I'm happy to do that when I take the time. Sometimes I don't always see them, but I try to post you guys and put your name and what you've been doing, because your friends all want to know, and not everybody does Facebook. Okay, that being said, we're going to start measuring, and I'm using just a little ruler here, and I want to come down an inch and a quarter on this, on both sides, and I'm going to draw a line, straight line across here like this. Now, one thing you can do is use what we call a triangle. I own one of those somewhere. Here it is. Well, it's easy to see how you could camouflage itself. If you don't know how you use a triangle, let me just zoom in. Let me show you. What you do is you take one side of the triangle and you line it up against something that's straight up and down. And these come in all sizes, okay? So you figure out the mark you like best, which is this one for me. It's the one I think says an inch and a quarter. I think I might move it up just a hair. Yeah, okay. And so I'm going to come across here like this and say, there's my... that's the top of my awning, and then I'm going to just come under here like this and do a small little valance. All right, now, That's cool. All right, so we can move along. That's good. That was easy. Yes, from there. Yes. So now we're gonna come in 2 inches on the side, and we're gonna put a dot right here about 2 inches. And how far down are we gonna go? We're gonna go down from there 4 inches from our awning, straight down 4 inches. So if I want a straight line from there, I'll just take my nifty triangle, line it up now this way, because I know that's straight, and just draw a little line like that. And that was the outside of this line. That's the outside of where our door is going to be, right here. That was the, should have been, yeah, 2 inches is the outside. So it's a an eighth of an inch is the little eighth of an inch. We want that, so we can draw that in. Little stripe down there on the inside going this way. Okay, so we want, there's our little, I think that's crooked. Goodness, how did we get crooked? I just told you couldn't get crooked. But you still, well, see, I didn't line it up on the top and bottom of the can. Look how off I was, honestly. That's why we use chalk, you guys, because it just erases. Okay, so there we go. How to straighten that out. Now, I want to go, say, from here, from this edge, it's, an inch and 3/4 from this to the other edge. So I'm going to put a little mark there. Inch and 3/4. And how far down? Well, it has to go down the same amount, doesn't it? It has to go down 4 inches. It's a no-brainer here. It has to go down 4 inches, about that far. And again, we'll do the straight line business. I'll show you how we're going to do that. I'm just going to come in here like that. Line this part of the triangle up here to the top. Figure out the mark you want, and just, I mean, you can do a ruler, and we're going to come in about, this eighth of an inch and do this other inside line here. Okay, so there's our, that is our, that's the width of our doorway. I'm going to just come across here, which I don't have to have a ruler for that. I'm just going to draw two straight lines in here. Now, our door comes in from there about an inch and 3/4, right like this, not quite inch, well, 3/4 of an inch, rather, right here. This our door comes down, and it's straight down 3 1/4 inches. So I'm going to come down like this, 3 1/4 inches, and then just draw a line to this corner, and this is going to be our door. All right. Ooh, so here, remember, the triangle has to be level with something that you know is straight. That's the deal. Okay, so there's the, that's the door. Now, the inside of the door has just a little window in it, and I'll show you. It just comes up like this. We're just going to draw it in freehand. Don't think we have to measure everything. You kind of get the idea. That's the inside of our door here. And then back over here, we're going to have a fireplace that's coming, that we're going to see behind the door like that. Nice little fireplace and some pots and stuff up here. So this is what we're going to be able to see behind it when you go inside the door. So might as well draw that in. I'm going to come this way. And we've got a window on both sides. So this one is, okay, this is interesting. If you just have the width of the ruler from the inside line, I'll show you. If you just have the width of the ruler from the inside line, however long that ruler is, you have a line like this. That's, then we're going to come up about an inch and a half. Let's say that's the bottom of our window here. So we've got a window here that's going to, if you're doing a gallery wrap, that's going to wrap around. So these guys all have to be the same height. Does that make sense? You want your windows. We've got another window over here that's very close to this one. I'm just going to kind of have to freehand it in. And it's got to be the same height as this one. All right? So we're just going to freehand that in a little bit. You don't have to have tape everywhere. This is okay. Pretty good. I'm going to freehand that one in. Here's going to be our center line right here. Okay, something like that, and something like this. And this window's open. I like this window because we said it was open. We said this window was open, this one's closed. Okay, so this is, oh, this is so easy. Come on, you guys, this is so easy. Here's a little round step, like a smiley face. And then we're saying that this is the, let's just kind of make that even, and here's the bottom of our canvas. Does everybody kind of see what we did here? I've just got this closed enough. So the big one here is our door, is our awning. This one's going to be where our hotel sign is. We won't have this line here. See, I like chalk because you can just erase it. So I'm just taking my finger and erasing that. So I know that this is my windowsill, and I can make sure that these are all the same. This line is equal to the other one by just using our triangle to make sure that our windowsill's ledges are even. Okay, so far so good. So what do we got, John? Anything going here as far as questions as I'm doing this? Okay. No questions. All right. So, and if you put this on here, this is the same size. It's hard to believe, but this is the same size as that, 6x8. All right, so that's all we have to draw in. Now, we need to paint something. So, let's paint something. I think I want to find my quarter inch ribbon. Just give me a second here, so I know where it is. Telling you what, nothing is, if you have quarter inch, half inch, and 3/4 inch, you've got the tape. It is the best. So I'm loving this. You can go ahead and use your ruler and mark these in. You don't need tape, but I'm just going to show you a tricky way. We're going to start with some tape, and I'm going to start here and just let me put something underneath this. I'll put the back of, I just don't want to tape anything down. Here we go. All right, so I'm going to just take in this tape like this. I'm going to hold it like this. And I don't want brown stripes. I guess we're not ready for the tape yet. All right, we have to take some gold paint. Now, yellow oxide, okay. And we're just going to paint in the top of this awning. This yellow oxide color. I'm using a little 3/4, let me see, what is that? 3/8 inch ruby satin silver angle brush. And I'm just going to go ahead. I'm not trying to get this too thick. I want some of the brown to show through to make this look like some sort of old awning. Okay, so I'm painting this on here like that. And while that's dry, we'll do something with the tape. Now, the nice thing about when you're doing stripes on an awning is that You can just measure and draw in the stripes and paint them in. Tape is such a wonderful trick that will show you how it works. But we're putting in a lot of vines and something over this. This is really kind of a neat 3D effect on this thing. So here we go. We're gonna say here's our awning color like that. Our gold awning color, just like that. All right. Okay, the question is, we have someone who's kind of new to our site and wants to know, what constitutes a complementary color? Well, that's a good question. So all you have to know is bicolor wheel, and any color that is opposite itself on the color wheel is considered a complement. Orange is a complement of turquoise, red, green, so forth. And the color wheel tells you exactly what it is. So that's a good question. If you're not sure what a complementary color is, I would say that would be an excellent one. Okay, so now, while I'm looking at this going, I know this is my window, so what else can we paint in here? Let's paint some stuff in that we can do. How's that? You guys up for that? So what do we know for sure? Because I don't want to... How much? Wow. Okay, so what we want to do here is I like to paint the inside of our stuff. So let's take some of this gold paint and let's come up here and paint the mantle. And then I'm going to come up here and paint a little bowl up here using just the corner of my brush. I'm going to paint a little, kind of a little bowl sitting on top of the mantle. That's cute, isn't it? And you know, you could do little candlesticks and stuff or whatever, okay? And then I'm going to take a little bit of Cad Red Medium and mix it into the orange, or into the gold, and I'm going to come right underneath there with a little orange line, and then I'll do a little orange accent. I know this sounds funny, but the details on this stuff is what makes it cute. The little orange accent on the bowl. Now, we're saying that this is a fireplace, okay? So how we're going to say that is I'm going to take some Dasani Purple, and I'm going to just say that this is very dark here, under here, like that. And I want it pretty dark back here on the inside. So a little Dasani, we did burnt umber, but it's a little bit of ultra Dasani Purple now back here. Okay, now you ready for this? I'm going to do a little chandelier. I'm going to take a little, on the corner of this brush, I'm going to take some tiny bits of yellow. And I come down here with about four or five dots, six dots of paint. And then I'm going to make a little hook here. And then I'm going to make a little hook on the other side. And then up here, I'll make another little hook. This is Ginger's standard chandelier. Okay? And maybe one in here like this, a couple little dots with the teeniest dots you can make, just using the corner of the brush. And then maybe you've got a little thing hanging down here in the chandelier. So now we've got a little chandelier. Isn't that cute? Let's zoom in. A little chandelier. Okay? And you can add a little white to that too. And you just want these tiny little dots. You could do a pointed brush, but the reason I like the angles is I never have to change brushes. I can just grab the tiniest bit of paint on the last little bit of the angle and kind of do what I need to have happen. Okay, so there's our bowl here up like this. Okay, here's our bowl. Now what I want to have happen here is I want to put some bricks. So I'm going to change brushes and go down even one more brush. You could do a tiny pointy brush for this, but I'm going to do a 1/4 inch brush and try to keep my hands out of the paint. Now I'm just taking gold paint, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a row of bricks going across here like this. 1, 2, 3, and then you know how you do bricks. You sort of stagger the next line and do another little row underneath it, indicating that this is a little brick fireplace, and it kind of goes, you can just make it go behind the door like that. See my little bricks? Well, that's cute. Now I'm going to take a little gold, and I'm going to come around here like this and gold in my arch, the top of the fireplace like that. So there's a little arch. And then I'm going to take some purple, and I'm going to come under here and skinny up the arch because I wasn't doing a very good job of arching this. Okay, ready? There's my arch. And let's see, now, yeah, oh yeah, then a little Cad Red Medium. And I'm just going to put little diagonal red bricks going around the arch of the fireplace. Now here's how we're going to say that we have a fire. We're going to take a little bit of yellow, and we're going to come in here like this and just splash up a little yellow. Take a little bit of red in here like this. Splash up a little red, and then do something with a little gold maybe down here like this and indicate that's a fireplace. Then take a little purple, come underneath it. If you get too much, you can push some back. I want a little bit of yellow on top of that for sure, though, bright yellow. Let this dry if I have to and come back with a little bright yellow. Maybe I can scoop some up. There we go, a little bit of bright yellow. There we go, there's my fire. Now I'll do a line across here like this. Got to make the hearth with some gold. Okay, like that. And now, this is the angle we're going to do the boards for our wood floor going in. Put a little bit of Cad Red Medium on top of that. Okay, and we're just suggesting. And the dark brown sort of acts as the line. So you see how we've got this. That's too red. We'll put a little more yellow oxide over that. Okay, so there's our gold floor, like that. And again, if you've got too much, you can do a little bit of, you know, purple. If you need to come back and put in some boards or something like that. And it comes under here like this, clear underneath our door, like that. Okay, all right. Kind of a glow from the fireplace. Uh-huh. So the question was, have I ever used the brand a sword brush? And I have not. I have not used that brand. But someone said they really like them. You know, that's the thing. You know, it's nice when we share brushes that we like. You help everybody. But I wouldn't think to pick that brush up either, okay? So now I've got a little bit of purple here. I'm going to just come in here like this, and the inside of where my window is, I'm going to put a little purple. And make sure that, how about in here too? Let's just come up here with a little purple and darken this up where our window is. And then just for the fun of it, grab some orange and just splash it on here like that to indicate somebody lives in this window. We'll do the same thing on the other side. We'll start with the purple, because remember, we just did the whole, just burnt umber was our underpainting color for this. So I'm gonna put a little purple here, then grab a little bit of orange paint, just kind of do that, indicate there might be a little light coming from here. We could do it in here too, just a little bit. Okay, so we wanna say, and then maybe a little gold too, that's always good. A little yellow oxide, it's a good gold color. Just come across here with a little gold in the window. Okay, so then later we can do something. See, you already see something happening here, don't you? This is kind of cool, and maybe I'll take a little tiny bit of white now and do a little white line like that. Wipe my brush off because it's dirty. Here we go, let's try again. A little white line and a little white line right here. Okay, this is still wet, so it's effective. Okay, so what do I know that's going to happen here? Well, I know that this is going to be a kind of a turquoise blue all the way around here. I mean, I can tell you, I know that, okay? And I know this is going to be a gold stripe here. So what I'm going to do is my next little bit is I'm going to mix a turquoise blue color. So I'm going to take some phthalo blue and some white and a tiny bit of yellow oxide. Okay, just a tiny bit of yellow oxide. I think I put two yellow oxides off, and a little white, okay? So I've got this pretty kind of turquoise blue, and then I'm gonna add just a touch of ultramarine to it and tone it down, just a touch, like about 5%. Okay, so now I've got this interesting blue. I love all the blues you can make with this. If it's too bright, add like 1% purple, and that'll tone it down for sure. Okay, so now I'm gonna come up here like this with this blue color under here, under my awning, coming over here like this. And I'm gonna, I think that's a little too blue. Wow, is that too blue? Let's take some yellow oxide and white and change that color in a hurry. We need to get a little bit more turquoise out of that. All right, but you can, this is an old building, so you can have fun with this. Doesn't matter, you just do another layer of color. Now we're gonna come under our window like this. And I want it a little darker under the window anyway, so I'll take a little more ultramarine blue. Say under the window it's a little darker. Just paint all this down to the bottom. Okay, blue. I mean, I know this is pretty easy. You just don't want all one color. That's what I want to tell you. You don't want it all one color. Okay, so let's do the same thing on the other side. It's gonna be, there's our door. You have to think about this for a minute. There's our door. That's going to be the yellow. It's got to be this right here. This is what we're painting. This blue color. And we're just going to pull it under here like this. One thing is a rule when you're doing buildings, it's just pretty much general. If you've got any kind of a window ledge, it's usually darker under the window ledge, maybe caused by a shadow. So sometimes you can just take a little ultramarine blue or something like that if you were doing a lighter blue, and darken it under there like that. Okay. Okay, so that's where the gold color is just yellow oxide. Gold color is just yellow oxide. That's the color. What did I use to make the gold? I'm still using cad red medium right now. I haven't even put the other one out. I think I have not put it out yet, so I may, but I haven't put it out yet. All right, so now I'm going to change brushes again, get that bigger one out. And I know I'm going to have, like right here, I know that this is going to be my step here. I'm going to have a step here, and then I'm going to have up here, I'm going to have a pot. I'm going to have a couple pots here that are going to go up into the wall, but I know they're going to be here at least. This part, and there's going to be a chair here, but we can just show where the pots are going to be. So that being said, I'm going to take a little yellow oxide and a little white, and I'm going to come under here like this, and I'm just going to add some gold, you know, some gold over my concrete, and maybe put a little tiny bit of orange with it, and a little bit more yellow oxide. And one thing you can do with yellow oxide is you can put a tiny bit of Dasein purple, which will darken it up some if you need to. If you need it a little bit darker, not quite so bright, darken it up. Let me say that there's our, you just don't want it all one color. That's the whole thing. You don't want this all one color. Let me say that there's our front step. This is all the stuff. You know, you look and say, what can I paint now without having to stop and dry something? So this is what I can paint now. And if I add a little white to that color, I can come under here and paint this part of the step. Right, like that. This is the sort of in part right here. This curve, kind of half circle, like that. Okay, so far so good. Oh, look at the progress we've made. We hardly have done any. Look at this. We're doing great. We're not going to get this done in an hour, but I bet we'll make this done in an hour and a half. It's not going to be an hour, but I think we're getting pretty close. Now, we need to pause and dry at this point. Okay, that's critical, because now we're going to start using tape. And I'll give you a clue. Tape doesn't like wet paint. So we're going to just dry everything, okay? So when I hit the hair dryer, let me just zoom back out. Let me move this out of the way. I don't even know why that's here. And let's see, so zoom back out just a hair. See what we got going here? Ooh, impressive, right? A little fireplace, something going. All right, let's dry it. 1, 2, 3, dry. How's our stream, John? Is everybody, are we still caught up? We're still pretty good? All right, John says we're doing pretty good, so we're lucking out. Okay, so here's our tape. What did I do with the piece I had? You saw me, I tore off a piece. What do you think I did with it? What would be your best guess? Oh, here, I found it. Okay, sort of stuck to me. That's my best guess. It's a tape, it stuck to me. All right, so here, what's the secret about tape? Let me tell you, use a palette knife to cut it. So we're going to come along here like this. I just put this on a piece of paper. I'm going to say, here's my first stripe. I'm just going to go right to the edge. Then I'm going to just take the tape like this and just tear it like this using the palette knife. Okay, and then I'm going to imagine about a quarter of an inch. Okay, I'm going to eyeball this in. If you were really careful, you'd get a ruler and measure all this, but I'm not going to do that. I trust you to do it better than me, okay? Okay, straight, squish that down. Then we're going to do the same thing. A little quarter of an inch, about a quarter of an inch width here, straight up and down. Use the knife and then just tear it like a scotch tape thing. Okay, and then we'll do it again. Quarter of an inch. Sort of eyeball that in. Make sure it's straight up and down. That's why you got to start off with one that's straight. Here you go. Okay, and you need a pretty long piece. This doesn't work if you have short pieces. You need a pretty long piece, and then you can keep tearing it. You need that long piece. And don't sweat it if you don't get it perfect, because we're going to cover most of this up with plants. And so anywhere you've got a mistake, just put a leaf or something. If these have got to be fun to paint, if they become laborious and you start counting, you know, using your ruler like it's some, you know, a math problem, then you're not going to enjoy the experience of this, I promise you. All right, so here's this one. And John says, unless you're a guy and you're going to enjoy it immensely. Okay, John, fine. Some of you, fine, you know. But those of us that find the ruler very tedious, yes? Okay, so I'm going to do this a little bit differently than I did on this one. I'm going to change the order of what we're painting. That's okay. It doesn't matter. I get tired of doing the same thing all the time. So we're going to just keep moving like this. Here we are. Let's do the end one like this. And then I'll just sort of split the difference on this one. Yes? Like that. Oh, look at that. Come on, is that good or what? Okay, look at that. All right, so then you burnish it down, and then you take a little piece and you go this way because you want it straight. Okay, so make sure it's straight. All right, like that. Now, leave a tail so you can pick it up. Now, since you've burnished it down, start with a clean brush. This is a really good plan. Some sort of little clean brush. Okay, here's a little half inch. This 3/8 inch Simply Simmons, and it's clean, dry brush. And I'm going to take white paint, and I'm going to paint over these gold spots. And I never want to go underneath the paint. I always want to go kind of overlap the tape, but never shove paint underneath the tape. Okay, this is not a good plan. And this is where, if you have like paint pens, you can do extra stripes on your awning. This is where you can do these decorative. These are very decorative pieces and really cute. And you know, you could put, I have a chair sitting over there, but you could put the family dog. You know what I mean? Just think about how you would personalize these little pictures. And really, you can name the hotels after yourself. That's always fun, or something like that. And you can just start changing the signs. It can be in any language. I've got most of these in French, but you could certainly change the language and do something else. And the idea is that these are cute. All right, see how okay, there's my white coming up here like this, up from the bottom. And if, again, this is old stuff. These are old awnings. So we're keeping it very simple. All right, see that? And you're going, yeah, I don't see anything. It just looks white. Exactly. So now what happens? Well, you start by taking this piece off and putting it in water. And then you very carefully start here. Let's just dry it real quick. Then I won't get my hands all dirty. So I'm going to dry it real quick. 1, 2, 3. Okay, now I take the tape off, it should be a little easier. Oh, look at that, you guys. Isn't that just cool? Look at these beautiful stripes. And people say they can't paint a straight line. Of course you can. Somebody yesterday wrote and told me, they said, listen, I really liked your video, but you went so fast I didn't have any fun. This is why you watch recordings, because the pause button is there, and you watch. The way to watch an instructional video, anybody's, is to watch the whole thing, see what they have to say, and then watch it again where you can pause it as you, because then you'll kind of know what the general plan is. That's the idea behind all this, you know, just do that. So, okay, so now what do we know from here? Well, now that's dry, we've got some cute stripes. And again, let's take our tape. Oh, I love the tape here. And I'm gonna say that my awning is gonna be, this is my, okay, that's gonna be this. And that's going to be this. Now see, she's going, what's she doing? This is trick number two. So if I'm saying that that's the width of those things, then I'll take another piece of tape next to those, then I know I've got it straight. Sometimes I'll lay out a whole painting in tape. Okay, there's the side. Let's see, where's the palette knife? I'll take this right here. I don't need it that long. Okay. And then I'm going to take this side. I used to have tape all over the house. It's a riot. Okay. All right, so there's this side. Now I'm just going to pull this piece of tape off, and that's the side I want. And it's going to end right here and up here. But I'll know not to go up any further than that. Okay. And then I'll use this piece for this side. And if you're using white paint, you can use the tape again. I've got used to have tape hanging all over the studio. I mean, you can throw it away too. If you're throwing it away, put it in water so that your wastebasket doesn't get clogged with tape. All right, so here's this. Okay, so I know it's straight, and I'll pull out the middle one here, like that. And then I'm going to say that that's the other side of the door. Sounds good to me. Sounds good to you. All right, so this is the other side of the door right here. Okay, so now what we do is the same thing. We squish this tape down like that. And I know they're the same size because I use tape as a measuring piece. I'm going to wipe my brush off. Go into white paint. Now I'm going to do a little white paint, and then I'm going to do a tiny bit of yellow oxide on this because I don't want it that white. Little tiny bit of yellow oxide on this tape. A little bit of white and yellow oxide, sort of a combination of that. Okay, since otherwise white would be a little bit too white. And the same thing over here. Say that this is the yellow oxide going around our door here. A little bit of white with that. Okay, and you paint over the edges. You see this? You paint over the edges. Make sure you're straddling the edges of this tape. All right, and don't go all the way up to your awnings. Make sure you're stopping there. And it's generally darker underneath where an awning would be, so you could have it a little bit darker as you came up to this. Okay, that sounds pretty good. So then what happens? Well, take this off. Take that one off. Take this one off. Take this one off. Take that one off. Okay, so now we've got our straight door. Oh, that's pretty good, right? And, you know, we're talking such small spaces. For the most part, much of this you could just paint in freehand. All right, like for instance, we know we've got a straight line going across this door jamb, like that, and I could paint that in. I don't have to have a piece of tape for that. I can paint that in. I think I'm competent enough to get that in here like that. Okay, here's our door jamb here. I know that's pretty good. And I've got a little gold here, and I'm going to come down here on the sides of this with a little bit of purple, I think. A little bit of purple on that. And a little bit of purple and red. Let's make a burnt sienna color. That'll be it. Purple and cad red medium. And I'm going to just come down here like this and paint in these steps. Like that. Okay, that's good. And let's see what else. Okay, so we know that we need a door, and we need to outline all of this. You guys kind of see where we are with this? So the question is, what would be a good idea to tape? Well, what you've got to do when you're thinking about something like this is just paint order, okay? Because we can do an awful lot of stuff, but I need these two main things dry before I can do the door. So again, this is where you want your hairdryer next to you where you're painting. All right, ready? All right, 1, 2, 3, dry. There, so it doesn't take long. It's well worth the trouble. Okay, so we're back to the tape again. Now I'm going to tape in the door like this, because I've already drawn it in. So here's my door. Make sure, when you take your tape, pull it between two fingers and then line it up and then put it down. Okay, so the door stops right here and it's at this angle, all right? So we're gonna go underneath the door now, so here's this angle here. And then I want a little dark line between the door and the gold. So where I've got to, if you imagine, I need a little, where it's gotta be is right next to this. The tape's gotta be right on this little white line right here, okay? So now I'll take the tape, and I can tape over the gold because I dried it, okay? All right, and then let's see, where else can I do with some tape? Well, whoops, pull that down and then twist it. Okay, so then squish that. Now, I'm thinking that the easiest thing to do, see, I get really lazy with any of this stuff. People say, how do you decide how wide to make a door? I say, I don't know, how wide's my tape? And I just, really. So I'm gonna say that this is my, if this is my window right here, which just happens to be, did you notice this? Just the width of this piece of tape, right? Happens to be that, okay? Then I'm gonna do, make sure this angle and the bottom are the same, right? I'm gonna tear the tape at an angle. Okay, so now I can paint around this. That's the inside of my window. So, good. Little brush, and now if your brush has been in water, well, pinch it off. Use a rag, pinch it off. Okay, this is you. I think we're going to put out a little nap of crimson now. I think I want it a little bit redder, so just a touch, maybe a combination of the two. So. Here's a little naphthol crimson with a tiny bit of cad red medium. And now I'm going to just paint over everything except where I know my awning's going, because I said. Okay, and I'm going to just say, here's my door. Just like that. Now we'll take a little cad red medium, put over that. How about a little purple? Let's age this door a bit. Let's put a little purple in there. Like tiny drops of purple here, like that somewhere. Age the door just a bit. Okay, paint right over the tape. Okay, so we're saying that's our window. Here's the door. Okay, so now what? Well, I'll pull off this tape right here, and I'll pull off this one. Okay, see how I left a little space? And I'll pull off this one. Let me just put that down. There, see, look at that. We got a little door here. And then what I know is I want under the door is a little purple, dark purple. So I'll just put a little, and that way if you got your angle off a little bit, you can fix it. But I'll put a little dark purple under the door here like that. Oops, didn't mean to go over that far. It's okay. All right, so there's the dark purple under the door. Now, well, you can kind of see where the tape is. I mean, I think you can see where the tape is, can't you? Can you just, kind of scrape this red off, and you can see where my tape is and where the rest of the window goes. All right, so I've already got the tape, so I might trust myself to freehand this door in a little tiny bit and just take a little yellow oxide and white. Now, the best thing to do would be to dry the door. That's the best thing. Just take a second and dry the door. It doesn't take long. Sometimes just that much. Okay, so I'm going to say that I come up here with my angle brush and say, here's my outline around the door. With just using yellow oxide. So there's the outline around the door. And I'm going to come up on this side, just kind of overlap the tape a bit. A little bit of white with it. So you can kind of see with this tape where everything's been. Just kind of keep everything straight. So if you feel that, if you feel pretty good about that, and then you don't have to tape every single thing. All right, I think I feel pretty good about that. Maybe not perfectly great, but close enough. Pretty good, anyway. And I've got it pretty straight, because I can look at this side of the red door and make sure this line is straight. Whatever I've done over there in here, I've got this line as a guide, too. All right, now I'm going to pull off the tape. Okay, so now we've got the inside of the door painted. See? Cool. Neat, right? Come on, it's a neat trick. And then the same thing with our windows over here. We need to just tape a window ledge. So let's do that. Let's take a little piece of tape like that and just decide how wide we want our window ledge. And just pull it like that, and then I'll come underneath here like, well, we'll do that in a minute. All right, I'm going to say I want this window kind of frame, I guess it's the frame, to be about this wide. Okay, I'm going to tear that off. Now, let's do it on the other side. So, here it is. It's just, interestingly, this window, do you see that? It's just the width of a piece of tape. It's kind of funny, really, when you think about it. And we'll do another one. Now remember, if this is a gallery wrap, you're going to go all the way around the whole thing, okay? You're going to go all the way around. We're just, for the purpose of this demonstration, we're not. Okay, so we're going to say it's about that wide. I'm pretty happy with that. Now, what could I do? Could I put something under here like this? Make sure that we're all straight here. I could. Like that. We can say that this is all straight. But I think what I would do then is pull this up. Like this. Pull this under. And then, right like that, I'm going to say that this is our... I don't know that that helps me. How does that help me? It doesn't help me at all. Yeah, it does. It helps me because then I'll come under here with... another piece of tape. I think I can do that. I have to think about this. You know, when you're just quietly alone in the studio, sometimes you can... Well, let's see. I'm going to come right up underneath it like this. And then pull that one off. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so we're going to say this is coming down to here like that. We'll just make sure it comes down that far. Alright, now, then we do this. As long, whatever you do on one side, just make sure it's the same on the other. That's all I'm going to tell you. Whatever you've decided, pick a width and then be happy with it. How's that? Okay, so now we're going to just squish this down. That's a little crooked, but, well, too crooked. The tape's a little tricky to get off, but that's okay. We have more tape. Here's a piece lying around doing nothing. I'll take this piece. Okay, and then tear it off here. No, not really. Tear it off here. Like so. Well, I think I'm going to start it at this end. It'll be easier. Bring it down here like that. Okay, so squishing this down. This is called burnishing, if anybody wants to know. I think squishing is a better word. But you can take the back of a palette knife, a spoon, something. Squish your tape down. Okay, so now we're back to the window ledge. And again, it's sort of an off-white, which is the white and a little yellow oxide. We're not getting too tricky with this. Coming down like this, little brush. And painting this in. The hardest part about painting street scenes is all the taping into the windows, the measuring. It just is tedious. But they're not particularly hard to do. I just think tedious is probably more the word for it. Because you just have to have, some people, you know, have more patience than others too. And in fact, if you're really clever, you can figure out how to lay the tape down so you pull one piece and it all comes out. That's a fun game to play when you're doing big windows. Is you just laying the tape down here. And, see. And then when you pull it up, they all come off if you've done it right. Alright, so now we're going to take that off like this. I don't think I have enough paint here. Alright, so good. Let's take the bottom tape off. Let's take that little piece off. Let's take these pieces off. Let's put the brush in water. Leave yourself a tab so you can get the tape off. Ha! Look at that. Isn't that nice? If you're a neat person, you really kind of like having the lines like this. Okay, so here we go. Here's this piece. There's this piece. Okay. This is not masking. This is artist tape. This is actual artist tape. It's designed for acrylics because it doesn't tear the paint up. This is called artist tape, pro artist tape. And I always get it in three sizes. And, you know, so I highly recommend that. Now, the same thing here. You can see now we're making good progress. We're about three quarters of the way done. Okay, we've made really good progress. I'm going to come up here and say I've got some pots here that I'm going to put in here. Two little pots like that. Let me just use some other chalk so you can see it. This is just sort of a line like that. And here's a smaller one. And then we want to come over here. We've got over in this corner, we've got a pot. Okay, like that. Some sort of little pot over here. And then here we've got this chair. Okay, now I'm going to bring this right next to the chair so you can see it. Here we've got to put a chair in here. So start with the straight up and down lines like this. You know it's going to come up about this far in the hotel. And then there's a straight line here like this. Okay, like straight line, like a U. You made a staple. Okay, can you see that? Okay, you made a staple. And then you want to move this over a little bit. This straight line like that, and then you're going to do this little angle here. You're making a box, and then here's the legs coming straight up and down like this. Make it fairly tall. This back leg and the back part of the chair are all one piece like that. And let's see, how did I do with that? I'm going to lower my staple a little bit. I have it a little high. Or just shorten this. Maybe I'll shorten this. That's what the chalk's for. And then we're going to say that there's the back of this chair, like that. Do you see how I drew it in? And you said, no, I don't see anything, Ginger. What are you talking about? We see nothing. Okay, so, all right, let me draw it on a piece of paper. Okay, so I'm going to draw it big on a piece of paper. You ready? So here's your straight up and down line. Here's your staple, okay? Here's your staple. All right, so then we're going to say this is how wide the seat is. We're going to move it over just a little bit. And we're going to make a little kind of angular chair like this. But this line and this line are parallel to the top and bottom of your canvas. Then you say, here's the front legs, not how long you want your chair. This back leg is even with this one. And then you go, maybe you've got a back like this. Let's see, how do we do this one? Yeah, just a couple of backs like this, kind of curved. Okay? And then maybe you've got, you know, a couple of lines like this. Okay? And then this leg would be coming down here because it's directly underneath this line. Okay? And then this would be your red, this would be your red seat. All right? Did you guys see how I'm making this chair? Like that. Okay. All right. So that's how you're going to put that chair in. Oh, good to know. Okay? So, again, this line here is parallel and parallel to the top and bottom of your canvas. These are the only ones that are in angles. So you're making a box. Okay, so that being said, I got my box too big here, so I'm going to just erase a little bit of that. Come back to my pencil, general charcoal pencil. I'm going to pull this down like this and say, here's my chair, my seat. There we go, like that. And say, here's our chair. Okay, got a chair, got a pot, like that. And then up here, we've got a straight line that's coming down here. This is where your triangle can come in handy. Would be a good place for the triangle if we actually saw the triangle again. The problem with translucent things, John, is they disappear, and then you're right in the middle of doing great things, really brilliant stuff. And he says, I have paint all over everything, and how could I possibly lose it? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I have no idea where the triangle went. It was here. You all saw it. Everybody can testify. There was a triangle here. Let me put that brush in water. It's just going to dry out. Didn't stick it under here. You know what I should make a point of trying to do is put it back in the same place every time. I do that with my car keys so I don't lose them. I guess I could do that with my triangles. Well, okay, we're faking it out here. Here's this straight up and down line down here. And then this window's open, okay? So that window's open, and so it's just halfway, okay? But remember, these cross pieces here come all the way across. They're the same. They should be the same height. So if you had another cross piece here, it's going to be here. And then we've got another one lower here, and then this window is straight up and down here, like that, okay? Now, you have the option of taping that or not, okay? But that's where it has to be. You have the option of taping that or not, or even using a pen to put that in. And I wish, I'm really annoyed now. Where'd that triangle go? Really, did it just, it must have been under here somewhere. Smooth. It's gotta be. What, how could, it's gotta be. We had a try, we have nothing, there's nothing here. There's a few brushes and some tape. It's hysterical. There's absolutely nothing here. And, it's a mystery. It's a mystery. Okay. It's gone with the remote. This is, I'm living in some sort of Twilight Zone vortex where the other remote never showed up either. So that the triangle has gone the way of the remote. Okay, so just keep in mind, the reason I was kind of looking for it, was it one thing you can do if you can't? You can take a piece of stiff cardboard. Oh, I have a piece of stiff cardboard somewhere. What'd I do with that? Oh, I found the triangle. It was right with the stiff cardboard. Oh, perfect. Okay, so now, here's the trick. I don't want a tape, but I still want this straight. Make sense? So I'm going to use the triangle as my guide, and I'm going to paint right next to, against the triangle like this. I'm going to hold the triangle down, kind of squish it flat on the canvas, and I'm going to come up like this and pick it up, and I've got a straight line. Assuming I had done the triangle straight, which I don't think I did. How is that possible? Well, it's me, so anything's possible. All right, so we're going to straighten this out. Sorry. All right, so I'm straightening out my line here. Right here. But you can use, the whole idea, the point behind this was you can use a straight thing that's like a piece of cardboard or something like that. And I'll do it here, down here, and make sure that I have this lined up. Well, I want the top of the canvas. This is a pretty little triangle. Line it up with the top of the canvas and figure out, make room for the width of your brush. Then you can come down like this, little white paint. Paint right next to the triangle. It could be a ruler, it could be a piece of cardboard. Okay? And just paint right like that all the way down. Now, this particular brush has had it, so it's not... That's one of my worn-out Simply Simmons brushes. I don't mind it's worn out because it was only $2 to begin with, but I'm going to show you just sort of the trick with these. Make sure you have the paint flat on your brush and not a big glob when you do this, because otherwise it's not effective. Okay, so come right down here like this. And what happens if you... go outside the lines a little bit. You can straighten it up with a little brown paint. All right, so I'm going to just very nicely pick that up, okay? So it's not as neat as if you were doing a piece of tape. It's just not, but it's something you can do. And then make sure that you've got, I'm just going to take a little angle brush here and do the little cross pieces and flatten out your paint, then come across like this, using the knife blade of the brush like that. Flatten them out. Like that. There we go. You say that there's our little cross pieces. If you tape everything, it can look less than painterly. So down as long as I'm in the white, I'm going to come up under here like this and paint my awning in. Okay, it's got a little purple on the brush, and I don't mind that. I'm going to come up under here like this and just paint my awning now. This little curved area here. And that sort of fixed the, you know, some of this. And there we go, just like this. Just make these little curved scallops. And, you know, I remember years ago I was teaching these birdhouses how to do these. So maybe we'll do a birdhouse sometime. And the really cute decor, I mean really decorative little birdhouses, a painting of birdhouses. And I remember showing how you would do checks. And this was at one of the painting parties. And I was just amazed. There was a couple women in there, and their checks looked like a computer had printed them out. They were so perfect. I mean, now I realize that there are people out there that are just that neat. I am not one of those people, but I managed to get by. Okay, so there. Okay, there's our little awning coming down like that. That's kind of cute. Now, the same thing with the middle of our... You want to put a dot where you want the middle of your window to be. Now, at this point, this is all going off to some sort of magical vanishing point off the canvas, like this. So as I turn it, let me just kind of make a mark where I think I want the two cross pieces. So as I turn my canvas like this, and as I turn this, it's going to be like this. Okay. All right. So those are my two cross pieces. And where did I put that brush? Okay. So now this is where the pens come in. When you're talking about this inside stuff, you can take a white pen like this, either a Sharpie or a one of these Uniball pens. If you need to, and let's just put a door handle here like this, too, like that, as long as we're doing a, you know, that. Don't be afraid to use a pen occasionally on something like this. Maybe just put a few little highlights. And again, if you want to tape this center line down, you could, or you can use a pen. A lot of different ways to do this. And of course, I want a line across here like this, where I'm saying that this window is open, right, on this side. And then, probably a brush that goes to a point would be helpful for the chair. So what you do is you start misting your paint a little bit, because you want this more inky. When you want the white paint a little inky, more like a heavy cream. So put a little water with it, then come straight down here with your chair like that, all the way down. These are these fun little European chairs. I love it. Then I'm going to say that there's my cross piece, and that comes in front like that. Here's my little chair coming down my little legs. Here's my other little white leg like this. Make sure that's there. Now let's put the back on like that. Let's just curve in a back, a little line like this, and a little line back here in front. So okay, so we're going to say you don't have to get too carried away with the chair, but that's a good thing. There's our little chair, and you could take, I don't know, maybe a little tiny purple if you wanted to, and kind of outline the underneath it if you wanted to. Come back with a little of the blue color and make it a little bit darker under the chair. It might be easier to see. A little shadow next to it like that. Just something so you can kind of see it. And then our chair happens to be, the seat happens to be red. So I'm just going to get some paint here and just paint the seat red, with a little bit of the white showing. Okay, so there's, and I'll put a little cad red on top to make it brighter. Ooh, look at that. Okay, so there's our red chair. That's cute. Now, this little pointy brush goes away. We get back to our pots. We haven't done those. So, Somebody thought we should have a kitten sleeping in the chair or on the step. It's not a terrible idea. Let's see where our time goes. Okay. Oh, I got to show you what I found. Can I show you what I found? Yes. Ginger, what did you find? Let me show you what I found. This is so great. Speaking of kittens, look at this. Look at this photo of kittens in flower pots. Is that not adorable? I think one of our villages ought to have a kitten in a flower pot for sure. I thought that was cute as could be. Really, just adorable. Okay, so we're going to take some Dosney Purple and about 75% Head Red Medium, and we're going to put in some pots here. Kind of some dark pots. Two little dark pots. Like that, and we'll put one in over here, like that, kind of angle it down. Flower pots, we're all good with that. And then I think I had in the window here, in our window, we had so much stuff in here. We had a little, like a little saucer in here like this. I'm gonna just get some of that soft white paint, like a little teacup or something. A little saucer and a little handle. Okay, and then we had over here, we had some cute little cups in here like that, in the window. We'll just put some little cups in. That's cute. Just little details like that are adorable. And how did that get there? I don't know. Let's paint that out real quick. All right. Well, that's nice. Okay, so now, okay, got to put the highlights on the pots. Now, the easiest way to do that, I promise you, the easiest way to do that. Oh, before we do that, let's put a shadow under the chair. A little purple shadow under the chair. We're in the flower pot color. So under the chair, let's put a little shadow. Maybe a little shadow off of our pots here. Like that. Okay, a little shadow under the chair. Never hurts to have a little shadow under the chair. Okay, now what? And I'm going to straighten this up like this with my dark. All right, great. Okay, so we straightened that up. We got the fireplace. We're on a roll, you guys. We're doing great. Now I'm going to take a second and dry those pots. Okay, ready for this? Second and dry those pots. Take long, right? We just had to seal them in there. Now rinse the brush. Red and yellow, you know, cad red medium and yellow make a really pretty orange color. Yeah, like that. About 50, not quite 50-50, about 75% yellow. And tap my brush off, and I'm going to come under here like this and say that this is the light part of my pot over here, and it goes into the dark side. The same thing here. Here's this kind of nice orange pot here coming this way. This one's a little redder. Put a little of that color here as it comes around. It's our pots. Okay, see? Ooh, zooming in. Where'd the zoomer go? Ah. Not to be fooled. I've lost it. Don't panic. And the triangle's right here, everybody. The triangle's right there. triangle's right there and zooming in. Okay, see how we get that yellow color? And we just lighten up the pot a little bit. Just come this way a little bit. And this acrylic's dry darker, so then just pure yellow over the wet paint. Just go this way with it and lighten up that pot right there. See? How cool is that? And let's do the same thing over here. Let's make this a sort of an orange pot now that we've painted it in dark brown. Okay, so we're saying there's a pot. All right. Now we've got some pots. Got an awning. We need the word hotel here. Something has to go here. Okay, I think we're pretty good here. I might put a little bit more orange in the windows here to make that kind of show up. I'm happy with the fireplace. Might take a little, remember I thought we need a little bit more yellow in the flames. Now that it's dry, I might do another little bit of yellow and maybe a dark log at an angle, like a crisscross, like an X, a dark log. There. Okay, so there's our little fireplace. Okay, there's that little stuff on the mantle. Now what? Ah, Okay, so now let's look at this awning. It's a little bright. The white, you see that? It's a little too white, even if we put stuff on it. So now we're gonna turn out the lights. We're gonna zoom back out. We gotta turn out the lights. So we're gonna glaze over this awning a little bit with a soft brush. And I think the color I wanna glaze it over is to probably an ultramarine blue and white. And not white, but well, just water. Let me just take it. That looks purple to me. Is that? Okay, let me just find some ultramarine blue. There we go. Here's some ultramarine blue, like that. And now I'm going to just rinse my brush off completely and come in here. I guess there's a little purple in this. Okay, now that's pretty strong. So the trisic, we're going to do a fast. We're going to do a fast stain on this white. All right. So I've started off. I've got a big brush here that's clean with just water on it. I come up here like this. I come across the top like this with the, and then I'm gonna just take some water and just sort of add a shadow on the top here. A little bit of a shadow maybe coming down from the top. If it's too watery, it won't stick. Okay, if you get too much water, this won't stick. But I just don't want it, using just my hands a little bit. I just don't want it that bright. So I'm just gonna say a little bit of blue. And I'll just mop that up here. Just doesn't take much. Just there like that. I'm just gonna, I guess, dirty up the white a bit. There you go. And I know that I've got coming down from the top here, I've got this stick that's coming down. So if I have a little shadow coming down from the top on this awning, it's okay. I can just kind of do everything at a little bit of an angle like that. So kind of tone down that just a hair. Okay, and then maybe I'll tone down the this too. Some of these whites here, I'll just maybe tone down a little like this. And the door, just tone that down. Just put, you know, kind of turn the white off a little bit. Okay, we're drying that. Now, here's the part where you get to have some really interesting fun. You've got to get out your gels. Now, I've got some heavy gloss golden gel. I don't have very much left. I've got enough to do this. Can you see it? I've got enough to do what we're doing. What we're going to do is we're going to take some dark brown chalk, and I'm going to say that I've got a bougainvillea branch coming. Let's see, let's try the dark brown. Got a bougainvillea branch coming down here like this. Like that, maybe just a couple, just like that from the top. Then we take our small brush with our burnt umber, a little dazzling purple, about half and half, and we come in here and we paint this, our little branch coming down. Now the branch is going to be a little wider as it comes off the top and smaller here, thinner. Using just the tip of our brush here, we're going to just do a small little branch. Okay, there we go. All right, that's all we're seeing happen there. Okay, like that. And I think that's pretty good. I think if we do anything else, it will be just maybe a little branch along here because we're going to cover most of this up with flowers. Okay, like that. Okay, and let's take, that's it. We're not going to see most of this. But I want you to see that we've got these on all the pieces. Okay, we've got this same, and see how our awning matches? See how our awning, I want you to see that. So when you do our, when we do, we're using the same measurements for the awning on our little village. So no matter what we do, you see, it all, everything lines up in our village. You see how cute that's going to be? Even though you're going to do different colored awnings. Each piece is its own unique thing. So, okay. So if that's cool, then what? Okay, so I think I want to take some white paint again and do a second coat of white on the chair because this is dried now. And it needs a second coat. Okay. All right, so we got a second coat of on the chair. Now the chair is kind of standing out a little bit more, a little bit better than it was. All right, now, oh yeah, let's do some little straight up and down lines right here for grout for our step. Okay, that's good. Just small little details like that. A little bit of a light lip here, a little bit of yellow oxide and white. Do a little bit of a light lip coming around the top of the step like this. Okay, everybody's on board with our chair. And let's see, that's going to be flower anyway, so it doesn't matter. This will be flowers. Okay, so now what do we do? Well, we've got to make some green, and then we're going to put the leaves first. I'm going to do a better pot here. I'm just going to draw it in here a little better pot here. Okay, because I can. I'll take a little pen and maybe fix those and then come back with some paint. Okay, so anyway, just wanted to put that in the window, a little bit cuter. All right, now, take a clean plate, which I happen to have a few somewhere. If you're going to do a complete village, if you're going to do two or three of these, save the flowers till the end, because you're going to mix so much of this, you can do them all at once. Does that make sense? You might want to save this. I know it's fun to do. This is the fun part, like frosting the cake. You might want to save this. So we're going to take a little bit of this gel, about a teaspoon of it. I'm going to put it in like two places like that. And that's that heavy gloss gel. You could use extra heavy gloss gel. You could use modeling paste if you want. It doesn't have to be gel. Gel will make it a little shinier, but it doesn't have to be. And just, now, we know that yellow and blue make green. Everybody's on board with that. So let's make a dark green. Let's take some of our ultramarine blue and a little tiny bit of our yellow. Let's make a maybe a little yellow oxide, as long as we've got some. Let's make a dark green here, like that. Now, let's take some of this gel and mix in there, about 50-50. See what I'm doing? 50-50, and I'll zoom in. Now, this is key here. This is not Brussels sprouts. Sometimes I see people and they'll do a branch like this, and then they'll put the leaves on it like this. I don't get it. Please don't do that, okay? So we're not doing that. So you're gonna have a branch like this. You're gonna have the leaves. I'm gonna show you. We're gonna drop the leaves on here. I just make sure I have my littlest brush here. Yeah, the 3/4 inch. I think I had a 3/8 inch brush in the bucket too, didn't I? Huh. Gosh, it's just extraordinary. I had a 3/8 inch brush. Y'all saw it. Well, they drown in the water bucket sometimes. I mean, that happens. They get down on the side and you don't find them because they're short handled. But I don't see it. All right, we're using this one. Okay, so I'll find it eventually. So I'm going to drop on some leaves here. Just drop them on, touch them like you're picking up peanut butter on your brush and just dropping it. And just putting a few little leaves coming across your bougainvillea like this. Going to drop it like that. Now, bougainvilleas, the flowers are actually the leaves too, so usually you don't see a lot of green. We're just going to see a little bit of this green coming here like this, and we're going to imply branches we've never drawn because we're going to put the green first. I'm going to say that there's branches that never happened. We never drew them in, but we're going to just imply them there because of that. Let's take some green off this awning. That's why I said you can't worry too much about how perfect you made your stripes. Let's see, I'm looking at that one. Maybe you've got some flowers coming up off the top of here like this, and we don't know. We haven't seen the branch. We just know that there's some coming this way like that. Okay, maybe up here like this, and I think we had some even up here like this in that picture. Okay, so then what happens? Well, you take some white. And you take some, well, before we do that, let's put some green down here on these pots. Same idea. We're going to put some green. We're just going to pop some green leaves Let's see, I didn't need to have white on there. Here, we're going to pop some green leaves on these pots over the lip. Maybe have something climbing up like that. Over here, pop some green. Now, grab some yellow, nice little hunk of yellow, and maybe a tiny bit of phthalo blue, because that's it. We've been using army green now, and a little bit of white. Now, let's make a lighter green, okay? Okay, let's grab a little of this gel, mix with it. Now, here we go. We're going to lighten up. The light's coming from the top. We're going to lighten up these leaves, and easiest thing to do is just touch the top of them with a dab of green, so you have the dark underneath and the light on top. And the same thing over here with these. You have the lights coming down from the top, so you don't have any light underneath the leaves. Let's make sure I have more white. I'm going to really lighten up this green with light and yellow. There we go. Now, if you've been using your brush to mix with, then you've got to wipe it off. So if you're saying you've got some light green leaves up here, the dark is underneath and the light are on top. And I don't care what kind of tree you're making, this is just a rule. Your lighter green leaves are going to be on top, and I want them light enough to show up. Okay, so I'm going to say here they are, lighter green leaves on top of this pile of leaves. Maybe coming under here in the window like that. There we go. And then they could come out by themselves. Okay, and the dark's underneath. And we've got that. And let's come down here and put a few lighter leaves here too. See that? Let's brighten this up. Let me bring that up so you can see it. I'm going to put a few lighter green leaves. One, two, three. One, two, three. Now the gel left on its own will stay wet for hours. We can skin it over. I can show you how to do the flowers. We can skin it over, but it won't be dry for a long time. Now, this comes back to our question of compliments. Not the kind of compliments you give me, like this was a fun lesson. I hope you guys liked it. But complementary colors. It's because red and green are complements. When you mix them together, you get mud. So, which means that if you're going to be fooling around with red flowers on top of wet green leaves, the green leaves better be dry. Okay, that's the secret. The green leaves better be dry. And I think I want a few green leaves, by the way, down in my street too. I think that's a nice touch. I don't know about your plants, but that's what happens to mine. Everything falls down on the pavement here. Okay, same thing with some lighter ones. A few little green leaves down here like that. Okay, so now John and I, what we're going to do is I'm going to move my ruler, and we're going to dry this with the hairdryer. And I can't really dry it, but I can skin it over, okay? And then I'm going to show you how to do the reds, okay? Alright, so that's kind of setting up. I'm going to get out another paint pen. This is a, this is called a deco color, liquid silver. I didn't really want liquid silver, I wanted white. And as I recall, these don't age well, these little pens. These do not age well. So as I recall, my white one, which one? That's a Liquitex paint marker. Let's see what that one did. Let's see if that. The problem is, you know, I don't think they don't last very long, and I didn't seal this with tape. I don't think there's anything in this pen now. See, I could sit here like all day long, and basically this pen is gone. I mean, well, wait, here's something coming out. I guess we could shake it up and see. All right, but basically, that's why I like the white Sharpies. I looked for one on Amazon, they were sold out. The white Sharpies. Let's see, you got to shake the pens. See, that's coming out in little globs here. Do you see that? Kind of like, that's not making me happy, and I don't think shaking it's going to make any difference. But I wanted to write the word hotel down here, So I may end up just using a brush. We'll just fake it with a brush. How's that? I'm going to just fake it with a brush. But I would have preferred a pen. But you know what? I can use a brush. Okay, so I'm going to just start with the H like that. I'm just using the corner of this bright brush. And then I know I want the L down here. H-O-T. So T is in the middle. Yeah. I think the T is in the middle. See, now I've got to, I want just the top of this. Just, I want just the angle of this brush right here while we're painting this in. Okay, so I'm going to say E. This is annoying having to cross over to get the paint. Let me just get my paint here. I don't like that one. So this is the advantage of drawing everything as you go. You can erase. Yes. Yeah, I mean, because I don't want to use the pointy brush. Cause, okay, so H. All right, let's just put the O like that. And here's our T. And then we're going to say, here's our E. Alright, so we've written hotel. That's not terrible. And we could do a little better job than that, but basically there's our hotel, and make sure that we've got a nice good L here. That's straight up and down. And you can go back over it with a little blue or something. Wow, that L really just wasn't happy, was it? Okay. So, let's fix the L. Now we got to fix the E. We almost rinsed that too. So here's our straight down here, L. There we go. All right, hotel. All right, I'm happy enough with that. Before I smear it anymore, I'll just dry it. Okay, so now we kind of, remember, we skinned these over. Did we dry that? We did, didn't we, John? Dried the green? No? Let's dry the green. Let's dry the green. Okay, skin it over. Now, what just fell down? This is how we lose things under the table. Something just rolled off. I don't know what it was. Brush, I guess. Oh yeah, that one. Okay, so here we go. Now, what you want to do, we still have some gel. This gel stays pretty good. And I think I will put out some fresh reds, because we've been playing in the reds a little bit too deeply. So let's put out some reds here. I'll put out a little red, a little cad red, a little naphthol crimson, and I think I have enough dosinine. Well, let's see, maybe a little phthalo blue right here. So if I want a dark red, I can take about 2% phthalo blue, make a dark red, and then I'll take a little gel and mix that in the color like this. All right, so again, we can go about 50% before you lose the color, whether your gel or modeling paste. You can do about 50-50. And somebody says, what's the advantage of this? Well, it's going to stick up and stay stuck up like frosting. And the other thing is that when you're doing large paintings with palette knives and stuff, your gels and your modeling paste are a lot less than paint, so your paint goes twice as far. That's a thought, because you use it up. Now we're going to drop on some red flowers, just right on top of these greens, and we're just going to tap them on, scoop up a little bit, and drop it on, like that. Just, let's see, can I get closer? Let's see, how do we get yellow on here? Yellow on the finger. We want to go closer. Alright, so now this is pretty dark. You hardly see it next to the green, okay? But I'm tapping it over some of the green, coming up here all by itself, using just the corner of the brush, and tapping on these little tiny, these are small, so these are little tiny dots, clusters of flowers, that are actually, you just got to imagine they're leaves. In bougainvillea, they're just leaves. Maybe we'll come over here on top of this green, very gently tap on a few, can cross over a couple places. Some of that green might disappear. That's okay, don't worry. Let's bring some down into our window. How about over here, coming down off the top? Maybe something came out this way. Like that. We'll just tap on something. All right, now, as long as we're doing that, let's take some white paint. And again, I'm going to put out some clean white because my white's gotten really dried out. And I'm going to add some white to my reds, okay? I'm going to add some white to the reds now. Lighten this up, and that's my lightest color. Can you see that? That's my lightest color. Okay, I'm going to just kind of roll that off my brush. Scoop this up. Let's get a little more gel with it. All right, now, what would you like to do? Okay, so you guys, as I'm painting this village in, and I know that I actually want to go into white. These little brush strokes are so small. I'm actually going to go into pure white at some point and let it mix in with the red because I want it to be a little bit brighter. Do you see what happens? Now the light's coming from the top. I said this today when I was filming the hat shop, okay, because we've got there's 10 in this series, and they're going to be on our website. Today when I was filming the hat shop, I went ahead and I did a giant example of how to do the flower pots and this, because sometimes it gets a little hard to see how to do that, and I don't know where I put the example. Here, I know. Oh man, did I do that on the back of this? Man, okay, I have to fix that. Here's a kind of example. I laid something on top of this, so it's kind of flattened it out, but I want you to see how you put this on here. So what you want to do is tap in the light, okay? So we're going to do a whole thing of villages, and you can find these, the complete collection in our, as we release them in our library on gingercooklive.gallery. You can collect them all. We're going to leave this one up, but the others will be at in our library, gingercooklive.gallery. And as we add stuff, we'll let you know what they are. And we zoom back out so you can kind of see it. Let you know what they are. Now I'm going to take a tiny bit of red, pad red medium, and just brighten a couple of these flowers up here, just because I want them a little brighter up here next to the green here. I'm going to brighten these up just a hair because they're not showing up. See that? Got them a little dark. We'll brighten up that red. There you go. Now look how cute that looks. Okay, so then down in here, this plant, we've got a couple choices. So we've actually shown three pots, one's behind another. So my first one is white. So I'll just put out some clean white. So I'm just gonna say I've got some white flowers. I'm just gonna take some gel. Now this gel, man, we're down to the bottom of my gels here, but that's okay. The bottom of my gels, but gels last a long time, and particularly I like the gold and the way they seal. So I'm gonna tap on some white flowers here like this. Just see, right up above here like that. Tap on some white flowers, okay? And then I wanna come over here, same thing. Tap on a few little white flowers here, dot, dot, dot. Okay, just make it sort of interesting. Maybe we've got some little cute little white ones right here. Tap it on. Okay. Then I'm going to take a little bit of this almost purple and red and make like a little lavender color. Take a little bit of the purple. Where's the purple? This is why we start writing on the sides, because after a while you can't tell where anything is. Okay, so here's my kind of deeper purple. I want a deeper kind of blue purple flower up here. I'm going to say that right up in here, I'm going to apply another plant behind this one by just doing the dark flowers, and then just come with pure white. I don't even have to put any gel with it, and just squish on top. And as I squish into the purple, it will turn to kind of a violet color because the light colored flowers are sitting on top of this one. See how I did that? This is sort of our purple basket of flowers. Of course, you could have yellow or something. It's up to you. And maybe we've got a few little red flowers coming down here like that. Let's just brighten up our chair again. Was that sort of cute? Now, how about our door? Do we need to brighten up our door? A little bit of cad red medium somewhere on the door. Brighten that up. Doesn't hurt to just get the door a little brighter somewhere. Okay, so you can kind of see there's a reds are those colors, you know, maybe I want it a little darker under here. Reds are those colors where you need two coats to really make them show up. Okay, so I would say that we're pretty close to being done, and I want to invite you to do the whole series. I think we're going to have a mystery. We're going to do 10 regular ones, and then we're going to do a mystery one, and we're going to have a contest about that, and a mystery one. And we'll let you know in the future what that's going to be, mystery contest. And here's a little dark line under here and under the door here, a little dark line here on the little step here, and maybe a little, we'll make sure we've got a little dark shadow next to the pots, under our pots. Here, make sure you've got something dark under your chair, like that. Okay, you can kind of see it. And you can kind of tell that we've got a pretty cute, I think our hotel is very cute. I'm really liking that. And the nice thing about tape, you're gonna, you know, assuming one could find the tape, the nice thing about tape is that, for me anyway, is that you can come along later if you're not happy with some lines. And it's easy enough to do. You can come around later and straighten up a line if you need to. Okay, so I'm going to just show you this line right here, this one right here. I don't know how long it is. Let me put this brush down. This one right here I don't like, so I'm just going to come with a little piece of tape right like this on the outside edge, just like that. Probably should have dried the flowers first. This is Russian roulette when you do this. Okay, then I'm going to take some dark brown, like that, and I'm going to come right here next to it. And straighten up that line, because it sort of irritates me. I'm just come this way. There. Okay, very carefully, because I don't want to touch the wet flowers. And I did, but I'm careful. Huh, look, see how it straightened up that line a little bit? It was a little too crooked. And that's the kind of stuff you can do. And then you can come back when everything's dry. And, you know, maybe you want a little green pot in the window. That's cute. Come by and, you know, play with something. Do a little bit of something like this, a little bit of a white windowsill like that. Make sure this is a little bit lighter. Come in here with some highlights. There's all, you know, a few little touch-ups, but that's basically, I'm going to show you, that's basically our hotel. If you did it on the gallery wrap, you know, you would see, you would keep going all the way around with your stripes and everything. But you can see this is how we painted these in. And I think this makes such a super series. I'm just really excited about this series a lot. I'm not going to think at this point, you know, it's quarter after nine, I don't think I'm going to try and put a cat or anything on the chair, but you certainly could put a cat on the chair. That would certainly be nothing wrong with that. If you wanted to put a cat on the chair, that would be a good thing. I think I'm the end. Save these jars. These are great. When you get down to the bottom of them, just wash them out and save them, because if you ever mix more gel, you can put them in here and save it. Maybe you mix too much green, you know, you're going to do something, you can save. The gel saves pretty well, I have to tell you. So there's our, you can kind of see, this is our, the start of our collection. You can finish it by checking us out on gingercooklive.gallery. And, you know, we want to tell you that one of the advantages of being a member is that we'll help you with these. If you're a member and you find these on our website, you can send in for $24.95 a month. You can send me your artwork and I will comment on it. So if you need a little help or something, that's the advantage. I mean, where do you get an art coach for that? So we think that's just absolutely cool. John and I felt that we would leave this up, this particular hotel up, to invite you to come try the others. And again, there's going to be 10 or 12 in the series. We're just going to keep painting these beautifully different little scenes in our village. And then eventually we'll do a village square. And I guess if you can get the gallery wrap canvas, that's really fun. One thing I like to do on mine, it's just a personal thing, is I like to sign all of mine Gonna just do it here too. I like to put cook on the step. Now the other day somebody put cook on the step and they thought it, they, I said, "What? Well, that's my name. What's your name?" Oh, you gotta put your name. You don't have to. Remember, this could be a gift for somebody else, and you can customize a whole village for somebody and give it to them as a gift. You can change languages. I'm kind of doing French on this, but you could do, you know, change languages. Here you go, put the slash and cook. You can got, you can see where you can come back and add a few little dots of color. Doesn't all have to be gel. You just need to add a little touch up of somewhere. And honestly, how fun is it, this? Is this a great series or what? So I'm ready to answer any questions. We're about ready to close up. We'll, again, we will leave this up. It takes YouTube a while to spool it, but it will be up. Okay, John, anything else? All right, well, we appreciate you very much watching. Thanks very much, and we'll see you tomorrow afternoon at 1, live class at 1 o'clock. If you want to rewatch it now, rewind now.